My name is Leah and I'm 20. I suffer from cystic fibrosis. Although I've learned to deal with my illness well, I found my transition from children to adult services really difficult. I wanted to make this film, which I hope will help other young people during their transition. Jake is 16 and about to make his transition to adult services.
My main worry about the whole transition process is the fact that all the responsibility is put on me and I've got to do all my own meds and know what they'll do. And at the moment, I've got my mum's help to make sure I don't forget it and do it. And as I go to the adult services, they'll want me to have that responsibility and not my mum. It's just the whole responsibility of doing it all myself is a bit daunting. Pediatrics. I've known for pretty much my whole life. I've been diagnosed when I was 6 years old. They're practically a second family, and I won't be seeing them ever again. And meeting new people will be hard. They won't really know me that well. They won't know me as an individual. They just know me as someone who has CF, so that's a bit sort of daunting and upsetting, I'd say, compared to here. They just know me as a person and all my ups and downs, positive and negatives.
Gabby, Jake's mother, has her own concerns about transition.
Jake is in hospital at the moment because basically he went to the Reading Festival, which meant for 4 days he didn't take any of his medications. And the impact was really severe, so he came in for a routine checkup and they admitted him as an emergency. I know that there are times when he doesn't take his medication. It's been very much something that I have done up until date. I've provided for him.
They said it'd be 47 kilos by the time I left.
He takes an awful lot of pills. He takes 40 pills a day, probably, plus. So it makes me very concerned about the transition when the onus is all very much on Jake. I find it very heart-wrenching that he's going to be moved to a different team and treated as an adult when he's not. He's a 16-year-old boy. But I understand that this is what we have to do, and there are obviously reasons for it.
Although a lot of young people will feel the same way as Jake, it's important to remember you're not alone. Laura is Jake's paediatric CF nurse specialist. She's been working with Jake to prepare him for transition.
Transition can be a difficult time for the patient and the parents because they're anxious of the unknown. We are there to support you and prepare you throughout this process and to make it as positive an experience as it can be.
Through antibiotics, which are permixin, which is inhaled, and then azithromycin.
Ultimately, it's about transferring your care from a child-focused care really to an adult-orientated approach. And actually, the adult team have got those skills and expertise that's needed to cater to the adult services. So obviously things about helping you go to university and prepare for your adult life in the future, and actually the adult services is the best place for that.
Samuel transitioned to adult services just 1 month ago. He's in hospital today for his second consultation with the adult team.
Keep blowing. Well done, keep going.
I was really, really worried about the whole transition process, but it's been absolutely brilliant. It started off with a pre-transition clinic where I met the whole adult team. It's quite worrying because you know, the adult team is so much bigger than, you know, what you're used to at paediatrics, but they're all so nice and they're all really friendly. You know, some of them are key researchers, key leaders in the CF field, and to know that you're being cared for by them, it's just an absolute privilege. It was really, really sad saying goodbye to the whole paediatric team because I've spent the last 15 years of my life, you know, getting to know them, with them caring for me, and suddenly, you know, you have to change, you have to leave them all behind, and there are all these new people that you have to meet. But I know that, you know, in 14 years' time, 15 years' time, that's exactly the same way that I'm going to be feeling about this new team. And what's more, they're going to be caring for me for the rest of my life.
They'll always get their own side room.
During your pre-transition meeting, you'll meet an adult CF nurse specialist. They will act as your transition link to everything and support you throughout your adult life. Susan is Samuel's nurse.
All of the CF adult services across the country are dedicated and equipped with dealing with patients and every need they may have. We do treat patients as individuals and we get to know them on a one-to-one basis and tailor their needs according to what they need. Every service will provide a dietitian, a physiotherapist, a nurse, a doctor, and in most cases, a psychologist. So we try to cover all of our bases. We do acknowledge that transitioning within the health service can be quite a daunting time. We understand this and we have lots of experience with dealing with most of the issues that do arise. And in most cases, patients settle quite quickly. But you know, if you are concerned and you haven't yet transitioned, you know, call your paediatric nurse or one of the teams and ask questions. Or if you've just transitioned, phone your adult team. That's what we're here for.
One fully adult clinic.
All the adult teams across the UK are skilled, highly skilled, and will support you as much as your paediatric teams, but just in a different way.
Yeah. Being responsible for my own medication is scary because I've spent all my life, you know, being cared for. And you know, bless her, I love my mum so much, but it's nice to know that I'm going to have a bit of freedom. If I start to be independent in my medications, I might take independence with my studies. You know, it'll be nice preparation for university. You know, it will help, you know, my friend groups, you know, that kind of thing. I really think it's going to impact well on my life as a whole.
For me, transition feels like a lifetime ago. And although it was a difficult phase, it had a really positive effect on both mine and my mum's lives.
Transition was quite scary. You know, as a parent for 16 years, you're dealing with the medical team, the doctors and everybody else. And then with transition, they start dealing with the young adult. And I said that to Leah. I said, always be honest with them, because if you don't, it's difficult for them to treat you.
It's scary at first because it's something new, but you're very, like, you're really supported and this.
Yeah, but after a couple of months, you know, it all slots into place and you think, what were we worried about?
I'm actually feel my life's changed a lot now. I feel more like an adult.
Responsible.
When I transitioned for the first time, they'd start speaking about your future. Like, so it makes you think about what you want when you're older. So you become more disciplined, like, with yourself.
And she really has. It, not just with her CF, with all areas of her life. She's took over and took control, and she's more mature. And she's very good. I used to worry whether, you know, she would cope with everything, but she has, and I think transition's been a good thing in more ways than one.
You fear that, you know, they're not gonna know you, that they're not gonna get to know you as a person, that you're just gonna become a name and a number on a chart. But just from the few appointments that I've had, you know that it's totally not the case. You know, they really get to know you as a person.
We want to provide our young patients with the tools they need to manage their own care, and for them to see that CF is not their life, it's just a part of it.
Transition is here to improve both CF patients and their parents' lives. Support is available throughout transition. If you have any concerns, contact your paediatric CF nurse specialist.